This week, This Is Your Life is enjoying a spot of fresh air at the Slimbridge Wildfowl Trust in Gloucestershire.
There he is. The man in my sights is, amongst other things, Britain's best-known bird watcher.
At the moment, he's in his natural habitat observing wildfowl while I'm observing him. You have to be careful in this game. You mustn't put a foot wrong.
This is day two of Twinkle's occupation of the City of London. All efforts to capture the kitten have so far failed. Michael Aspel, BBC, London.
The name on our book also helped create these classic moments from the BBC archive. He was one of three musketeers, ever ready to leap on their wheels to take on anyone, anytime, anywhere. He also happens to be the star of some of Britain's best wildlife films. This multi-talented man is 5'4" and hairy. In bird lovers' terms, he might be described as the lesser tufted all-rounder.
This is a person of extraordinary, intense, manic energy. Never, never sleeping, always restless. If you could bottle him, you'd probably give an entire city going for an entire year. I mean, someone of, dare I say, almost manic energy, unlike myself.
And he's at Slimbridge today, introducing another wildlife film.
On a boat.
Time to wade in.
Bill Oddie goes wild. And I will go wild if you nip me. Now, come on. Gently.
What a kind man you are. What a kind man you are.
Oh, no. Linda,
would you just smile and look at the birdie, please? Because I've squelched many miles to say, Bill Oddie, this is your life.
No. I always said I wouldn't do it, and I won't. Oh, I'm sorry.
Bill, we've got loads of friends hiding behind the bushes waiting for you.
Absolutely not.
At our studios.
No, I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
You won't do it.
No, I won't do it. No, I've always said I won't, and I won't. Sorry.
Well, that totally unexpected reaction presented us with a real dilemma. Guests were already arriving at Television Centre, but Bill was heading off to his home in London. Could his family get him to change his mind and join the party?
Ladies and gentlemen, you saw what happened out there, so I don't really know what to say except Bill Oddie. Well, the eagle has landed, but for a while we really thought the bird had flown. What was going through your mind, Bill?
What's going through my mind now is that I'm a gutless creep with no principles whatsoever.
Was this something you really didn't want to do?
Yes. And if Tim and Graeme are on this programme, I'm going to be equally upset and embarrassed by their lack of resolve, because we agreed many years ago that we wouldn't do this programme, you see. And I was just being true to that... ring.
Nothing personal, I hope.
Nothing personal to you, no, but I suppose this is your own back, isn't it, for that clip which we've just seen. It really is sad when a man of his stature holds a grudge for, what is it, 40-odd years.
Well, I'd better get started at once anyway. As you've noticed already on their perches, friends and colleagues, your aunties, Marion and Marjorie, and now the people who are perhaps closest of all, your wife, writer and broadcaster, Laura Beaumont, with daughter Rosie, and your other daughters, choreographer and dancer Bonnie, and actress Kate.
Your daughter's pregnant.
Now, that's nothing to do with this programme, believe me.
I hope not.
Now, Laura, you've been married for 18 years, haven't you? Perhaps. And you had a very special honeymoon.
Yes, I suppose it was quite special. Bill was doing a documentary on Papua New Guinea, and it was all about birds of paradise. It was in the rainforest. So we decided we'd combine the two things, or he did. And so the thing about the rainforest is it does rain all the time, which is fine if you've got, like, you know, a roof and some walls and that kind of stuff. But we were on the edge of this slippery mountain on a tiny piece of plastic with about 25 other people and lots of very huge creepy crawlies. So big, like you'd think they were your pillow and then they'd sort of crawl.
I think there's a television series in that.
Absolutely.
There was a television series in
that. Bill Oddie, this is, after all, your life. Over the past 40 years, you've written and starred in hundreds of hours of radio and television comedy. You've appeared at rock concerts and at the English National Opera. But you're best known as one third of the Goodies. Hey, why don't you give us a shout, man?
Say anything but nyeh.
Nyeh. I was given a ritual bath to cleanse my imperfect body, and the water was softened with exotic unguents.
The funky gibbons.
Funky gibbons.
Just like you, come on, you funky gibbons now.
Goodies. Goody, goody, yum, yum.
Goody, goody, yum, yum, they are here. Tim, Brooke-Taylor and Graeme Garden.
Are they still alive?
I'd like to award his cap for being a gutless creep.
Thank you. I'll go along with that.
Like the rest of
can
us.
Can I sit down?
Yeah, you can.
Graeme, is don't there a story under there?
Under here. It's about all there is now.
History?
Yes, well, I mean, it's a joy to be here to betray Bill's principles. And he is a man of enormous energy and always makes me laugh. And Tim and I were talking. I remember there was one episode where he played our pet. He took on the character of a little mischievous, naughty puppy. And that sort of summed up our working relationship, really. There was no acting required from Bill at all. Or us.
And in fact, when he laughs, he really laughs. Oh, just like that. And like a naughty puppy, he lets out a little sound. And it's not out of his mouth. And,
I'd just like to say that actually, the great thing is we're still great friends, which I think is pretty marvellous, but the really
good
thing...
That's because we don't see each other much. Right.
But the great thing I'd like to thank you for is writing the music. What a pity that Graeme and I went and spoilt it all. But the great thing, you got us on Top of the Pops, so we had all those millions of groupies just around the corner. And you're a naughty boy.
Gentlemen, thank you.
Naughty.
Now, one of your early opportunities came in 1963 with the late-night satirical romp That Was the Week That Was. And here is a quick hello, good evening and welcome from Sir David Frost.
Bill, it's great to greet you on this happy occasion. My memories go back to times at Cambridge, that marvellous sketch you wrote, BBC BC, an Old Testament newscast. The weigh-in for the big fight tonight, David tipped the scales at 13 stone 4 pounds and Goliath at... stone 4 pounds. Goliath's manager said later, the odd stone could make all the difference. And then there was my only ever single, really, in the pop world, was a spoof of Wink Martindale's Deck of Cards, which again you wrote the magic words for. I can only say that with your music and everything else, you are undoubtedly the most versatile ornithologist I know.